All right. The real estate sector is once again betting big on the Union Budget 2015-16. Tax swaps and higher tax exemptions for home buyers, clarity on REITs are some of the issues that top the expectations of the industry. But will this budget be any different? Will the government live up to the expectations of the sector and deliver what the sector has asked for? Oinitham Ojha reports.
I proposed of setting up a mission of low-cost affordable housing.
It is delivery time yet again for Finance Minister Arun Jaitley. The beleaguered real estate sector is now hoping for concrete solutions to revive the sector that has been battling subdued sales and damp consumer sentiments.
The first thing would be to empower the buyer and actually allow the exemption under Section 24 of the Income Tax Act from 2 lakhs currently to 5 lakhs.
A long-standing demand of the sector has been to get infrastructure status or include the sector under priority sector lending.
This sector has been, is not getting finance at a, right time at right cost for quite long time. So I think if the real estate sector is given the infrastructure status, access of people to the formal sources of finance like banks and financial institutions will certainly go up and will go a long way in making the real estate affordable.
The sector's wish list appears to be a photocopy of the list over the years with just a few variations. Rationalizing provisions under Section 54 of the IT Act, which says you can invest proceeds from sale of property into housing within 3 years, else it will be added to the income. Industry wants centre to issue directive to state governments to align circle rates with market rates, developers be exempt from taxes on unsold inventory, reintroduce tax swaps on SEZs and investments in SEZs be exempt from minimum alternate tax and dividend distribution tax for 5 years as was proposed earlier.
Don't tax it more than the other sectors. If we all agree that housing is required, we keep saying that we need 20 million, 30 million more housing, and we need more urban cities, we need smart cities, and we have to be very clear that even in the private sector, developers who are willing and who have come with new understanding of how cities have to be developed, how housing is required, of what quality, if all that is, there is clarity, then create a conducive environment.
6 months into the announcement of REITs and the sector is still awaiting clarity on taxation issues.
The finance minister in his budget speech had announced that he would allow pass-through taxation. Now that actually has not happened, within the rules and regulations of the direct taxes. Therefore, what we would like to see in this budget is that the promise of pass-through taxation is actually delivered, whether it is MAT, whether it is DDT, MAT is minimum alternate tax, and DDT is the dividend distribution tax, and these are done away with.
The tax breaks which we expect are, first of all, the exemption limits of the interest and principal amount for the loan which has been taken by home buyers, whether existing or the ones who are planning to take in future. Those exemption limits should be enhanced. Currently, the principal component of the interest, it is clubbed with Section 80C of Income Tax Act. I think it should be a standalone component.
This sector contributes a little over 6% to the country's GDP and is the second largest employer after the agriculture sector. So will Mr. Jaitley announce some goodies for this significant sector and bring the cheer back? All answers on February 28th. In New Delhi, Oinitham Ojha, NDTV.
Time for a small breather on the property show.